Let us perform convolution integral between two signals where x of t is given as a unit step function. Also h of t, that is an impulse response, is given as another unit step function. Y of t thus is the output of convolution between the two signals. And the formula of y of t is integration from minus to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. In the first step, we change index of both x of t and h of t to tau and sketch both the signals. In the first place, x of tau, which is a shifted unit step function and is an advanced signal which starts at t equal to minus 1, is sketched. In the second place, h of tau, which is also a unit step function but is delayed by 2 units, is sketched. In the next step, we perform folding of h of tau to obtain h of minus tau. Thus, this time reversed h of tau function is sketched in the next position. Followed by folding operation, we perform shifting operation on h of minus tau. So, it is h of t minus tau. Thus, the folded and shifted unit step function is shown in this position. In order to ensure whether we have correctly put the time variable as t minus 2, we can substitute t as 0, which will result into a same function as h of minus tau. In the next step, after folding and shifting, we'll start sliding off a signal h of t minus tau over x of tau. We'll perform this operation till both the signals, they get overlap. In the first place, or I would say it's the first case where x of tau is fixed and h of t minus tau is shown, which indicates there is no overlap between the two signals. Therefore, the output of convolution, which will take place from minus 1 towards minus infinity, will be equal to 0. And this will happen for t less than minus 1. As we start shifting and sliding h of t minus tau over x of tau, a time will come when both the signals will overlap. At present, an overlapped portion is shown as the dashed area, and the overlap takes place from minus 1 instance of time of x of tau and t minus 2 instance of time of h of t minus tau. Therefore, the integration limits will be from minus 1 to t minus 2. Now, in place of x of tau and h of t minus tau, we put the amplitude values of both the signals as 1. Followed by that, we'll perform the integration, and after putting the integral limits, output appears as t minus 1. In the third place, from t minus 2 to infinity, again there is no overlap between both the signals. Therefore, the output remains 0. Thus, the total output of convolution will be y of t as 0 from t less than minus 1, whereas y of t is t minus 1 for t minus 2 greater than minus 1, greater than or equal to minus 1. After simplification, that leads to t greater than or equal to plus 1. Thus, From the nature of the output, we make a conclusion that it is a ramp signal which is shifted by one unit. Hence, the output is sketched as shown in the figure here.